Once again, we're in the offices of Professor Malenko's Family Enterprises. Again, this television time paid for by the professor's Family Enterprises to discuss the indefinite suspension brought about by the National Wrestling Alliance on the Masked Superstar because of the incident involving the Mighty Igor and the burning of his eye. Professor, your man is suspended. I'm sure the fans would like to know what he's doing now, but I'd like to ask a question. You and the Superstar have continually yelled foul that this was, in actuality, an accident. Could you explain to me exactly how this accident took place when you're...
Wait a second. Wait just one moment. I'm paying for this airtime, not you. I'm going to do the talking. Superstar's going to do the talking. We didn't come here to get to put it to a third degree or something. Now, this is not a court of law. I want to say this, Superstar. We're staying here in limbo. We have nothing accomplished here. There is nobody in the world that would want to hear from me on a telephone about getting you booked in any part of the world. There's something that has to be done.
I want to ask you something, Les Thatcher.
Ask away.
You're in contact with these NWA officials every day. Is that not true?
That's true.
When are they going to let me come back to wrestling?
Well, that, is, of course, is not up to me. That's up to the Board of
Regents. No one will ever talk
Wrestling
to me.
Alliance.
I call up as soon as they find out who's on the other end of the phone. Boom, and hang up. For nothing. I committed no crime. It wasn't premeditated. It was accidental. I didn't grab the cigar. I didn't jam it into his eye.
Here again is the accidental thing is brought up once again.
I don't want to hear anything from you.
This time is being paid by me. Do you understand that?
All right.
All right, you keep on making these accusations time and time again. Now, the people know one thing, that this is one of the greatest wrestlers that has ever been seen. He doesn't have to resort to things like that that he's been accused of. All he knows is one thing. This is an injustice that is being done us, the family of Malenko.
Accidental or premeditated? Certainly only the Masked Superstar and Professor Boris Malenko know the truth.
We're getting ready to go here pretty quick, and I would just like to say, as long as every one of us here has a love for each other, this country and everybody in this country will remain free, and this will be a free place to live. Love is what it's all about, and just because you may not be like somebody else, that doesn't make you less a man or a woman. And we have love together, and that's what makes all this possible. Thank you very much for inviting all of us to here today.
Why do you like Championship Wrestling 80 the best?
Dusty Rhodes.
Dusty Rhodes is your favorite wrestler? Why is that?
Just like you!
Gordon Sully!
Gordon Sully is your favorite on the show?
My man! I like the Steve Kerr forearm!
Who else are your favorite wrestlers?
Dusty Rhodes!
What do you like about Dusty?
Yeah, he's the man of the hour, the man with the power!
What do you like best about Championship Wrestling 80 coming to your area?
I love it!
Who's your favorite wrestler?
Dusty Rhodes!
Why do you like Dusty better than anyone else?
He's a honk!
Dusty's a honk!
Judy Martin being caught now makes her tag up with Lalani Kai. Vicki Williams and Joyce Grable going after the World Women's Tag Team Championship. Tag is made. Here you see double teaming by Vicki Williams and Joyce Grable. They have taken a lot of abuse so far in this match. Watching very carefully now as the action continues in the ring. Judy Martin once again in the ring. Joyce Grable finally breaks that hold. Tries to make the tag, but Vicki Williams unable to do so. Don Serrano, the referee, watching very carefully. Good takedown, Lani Kai caught. Vicki Williams catches her, good flying drop kick. Catches her again, and now the tempers are really beginning to flare. Williams and Grable out to gain those titles if they can. Lalani Kai caught once again. A good, beautiful flying drop kick. Puts Judy Martin back to the canvas once again. Her down. Vicki Williams catches her. A good high knee lift once again. Now Joyce Grable back into the ring. And Judy Martin finally leaves the ring. Here's where Martin and Lalani Kai get themselves upended by these two young ladies in blue who want the Women's World Tag Team Championship. Both of them missing with flying drop kicks that time. Lalani Kai now. Williams up and over. rolling reverse into a cradle. And there you see two very jubilant young ladies.
Warfield House in Atlanta, Georgia. And what action there has been. The fans are enjoying it. There's a tag. Apollo's in. Argentina Apollo finally gets in. Beautiful flying drop kick. Beautiful flying drop kick again by Apollo. Oh, what a maneuver. Look at Apollo. What can you say?
This could be it, but not. The assassin kicked out, but that Apollo really is like a whirling dervish.
Beautiful cartwheel by Apollo. And you better believe the assassin respects this man. And he backed away for that reason. However, you'll notice he did not tag in his partner. Now he does. Apollo, I believe the assassin wanted to have a little more of Apollo there, but Jerry Brown said, let me come in.
I'm sure that must have been the case.
Well, Apollo is a mystifying style of a wrestler. He's hard to figure out. So unorthodox. Watch him bounce away. Brown continues after him. Apollo behind. Brown goes down to try to come out. Apollo stays with him. He moves away again. Brown tried to sit out. Brown could not sit out. Buddy Roberts comes back in. Roberts with the head scissors again on Apollo. And now Roberts stopped the offense or the offense of Argentina Apollo.
A lot of times, Ed, I've observed that once the momentum gets rolling, a man can be very dangerous, but once he gets stopped, like in this case now, it sort of takes the starch out of him, and he loses some of his enthusiasm.
You will find, as you travel around the country, some of the greatest fans in America are right here in Georgia. Roberto Soto tags in. I'm glad you're here, Ray, because this match has been so exciting, the crowd so loud, I'm about to lose my voice.
There hasn't been a moment of inactivity since this match began.
Headlock snapped on by Soto on Buddy Roberts.
Big time wrestling will feature many of the big stars of professional wrestling. And I guess they don't come any bigger than the Sheik, the United States champion. This fellow has been a remarkable attraction for some time now. You will note that Von Erich is shooting the thumb to the throat of Dubois, but of course he lies very convincingly to the official. Nevertheless, that extended thumb is a dangerous weapon. The chant goes up from the fans. Go, Gene, go. And go he will if he gets his chance. A nice headache for Von Erich as he hit the turnbuckle hard and whoa, that boot to the midriff sent him flying outside. Von Erich takes full advantage of the count, although the eagerness of Gene Dubois is giving him extra time outside. The referee will not count unless the opponent stands back. And Dubois goes out after him. And Von Erich is on the move with Dubois right on his heels. So far, they are ignoring the ring where the wrestling should be taking place. And both men got in to escape the countout. Again, Dubois collects that boot of Von Erich's, the boot that has made him famous. There's a 20 count out on the floor, and Dubois hit the boards hard. And the bell is called for, and hello. The ring announcer will let us know what has happened.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner, 7 minutes and 30 seconds, by disqualification, is Gene Dubois.
Well, wow. Boy, listen to these fans scream. As Laird is getting up, Laird is getting up to his feet. He is up. He's fought his way back to his feet. And these 12,000 fans are screaming. Ernie Laird is up. Oh! He throws a tremendous punch. Another one. There's that thump to the throat. Another thump to the throat. Now he's punching the ox, Ernie Laird. Is after the ox, the referee has been knocked out of the ring. Oh! Starr hit Laird with that chair. Laird was hurt. He was hit with the chair. Laird is on the outside. The referee is counting. The referee did not see Starr hit Laird with the chair. Laird is hurt. He's counted out. The match is over.
The most violent man I have seen in this game, and that proves it right there.
You know, Al, I keep thinking about you. I tried to shake your hand at a match a little while ago, a couple matches ago. You walked away with your nose up in the air. I know you're a good friend of this Bob Luke that wants the bruises to beat up on me. He wants to stop me like a bed bug, and you would be happy to see it too. Why are you even on this program with me?
I'm
the Godfather
you.
Sent you here to try to... Look at that smirk on your face. I want to tell you one thing. I don't like you either. And if you don't get over here by the time I count three, I'm going to give you one of my... Okay. I'm going to start count one, two. Did you see that, ladies and gentlemen? He run off because the tear that I have in this fist of mine. And Bruiser, all I can tell you is, I don't care if the Godfather told you to beat up on me. I'm going to use this fist. I'm going to hurt you. This L Learner, did you see the smirk on his face? The Godfather, who's not man enough to come here and interview me, he sent this L Learner here, and now I'm here by myself. Why do I need them people? I got the heart punch. I got Dick the Bruiser in there. And I'm going to tell you, he is supposed to do a job on me. But with this one punch, Bruiser, first it was Laird on the ground. All I can tell you, don't get down. Don't lay with your back on that floor or you're going to get hurt. And if Bob Loop, if you're anywhere near there, you're going to get hurt. And Al, I wish he'd have waited till I got up to three, because I'd have hurt him too.